I gotta burn them out. I gotta make it safer to ride.
Information? What information? How could you possibly have left to say?
Should be it.
So what the hell?
I managed to recruit a few guys who I trust, who like me, aren't happy with what's going on.
So why am I here?
I wanted to give you this. You were right about your wife.
How did you get this?
When Silver Lake evacuated, they took NERO personnel, federal officials, and well, Sarah Irene Whitaker had a Class 4 federal clearance level.
Clearance level?
The wife bugged out with a recon unit, east of Fort Rock.
Take me there.
No.
No. Well, you got a ride. We're all friends now.
The base is gone.
What?
A year ago. Local militia group.
Militia group? Where's their camp?
We don't know.
How the hell can you not know? You got a helicopter. You got satellites.
Somewhere around Crater Lake, but it's a no-fly zone, okay? They got outposts, rockets, RPGs.
Crater Lake.
Crater Lake. I wanted to tell you about the work we're doing. Studying the infected, the freaks. They're evolving. As bad as things are right now, They're gonna get worse. A lot worse.
Use this. I go to hell, O'Brien. I don't give a shit about any of that.
Boozer! Boozman, come back!
Yeah, Deke.
Hey, listen to me. A year ago, we were with Iron Mike. We were thinking about riding south, but the Santium Pass was blocked. There was no way through, and he said that he knew another way.
Deke, Iron Mike is not too happy with us right now.
Just listen to me. Do you remember what he said? But God, if there's even a chance that she's alive, I gotta find her.
Goddamn right. I gotta go. Ricky and Annie need help putting up a shelf or some goddamn thing. Look, I'll see you when you get back to camp. Who's her out?
See you. Cope, I gotta say, I don't like it any more than you. Do your worst.
Yep. Hey, Deke. Be safe.
All right, let's see what the old man's got to say.
You know a way over the Teelson Pass. You told me once that
I told you nothing. Go on. Oh, I can't help you, Deke.
Just draw me a goddamn map.
After everything you've done.
After everything I've... What about what you've done, old man? Huh? Sherman's camp, the things that you
get out of here. You leave me.
Listen to me. Listen to me. What if you could take it all back, huh? What if you could fix it? I thought I put Sarah on a chopper. I felt relieved. How fucked up is that? I was relieved, Mike. That's what I've been living with.
And now you're chasing ghosts. You think finding your old lady, if she's alive, you think that's gonna fix it? Make you whole?
I don't know, but I gotta try.
All right. If I do this, what you want, show you the way over the pass, you don't come back. All right? You promise me you don't come back.
I got you.
Shit. Now I gotta talk to Boozer.
Sounds like there's some kind of machine down there. Taking a bite to the goddamn freakers. Come on, we're up here pissing our pants about a bunch of freakers.
There. What's blocking the road? Snow and ice?
We just wait for it to fall. There's a bunch of
holy
Boozer,
shit.
You're right. I.
Last winter, we were up on Farewell Ridge. We were watching the freaks. Thousands. Thousands of them. I mean, too many to count.
Yeah, I remember.
All I could think was, every one of us, man, woman, and child, are now homeless. Bunch of goddamn refugees. Yeah. World belongs to them now.
We'll survive.
Yeah, we've been doing that all right. Surviving isn't living. Something Jack used to say. Doesn't matter when you hit the road, where you're heading out to, but you damn well better know where you're coming home to.
You know, we never talked about it. While we still wore the colors all this time out in the freak show and shit like this didn't matter anymore.
Yeah, but I think. Last two mongrels on Earth, Farewell Originals.
The biker boys, most badass drifters on the broken road.
Damn straight.
Yeah, I guess we did become sort of a brand.
We were a lot of things, but we were never a brand.
When we rode out of Farewell, without Sarah, without Jack, or anyone, I knew that we were leaving everything behind. Everything that mattered was gone. Said this.
You got Nomad again, huh?
Yep, I guess I am.
Come on, Jack. Inside, let's go. If she's out there, you'll find her.
Deke, you ready?
Yeah, Mike, I'm ready.
Meet me at the gate. Don't keep me waiting.
Yeah, sure, Mike. Whatever you say.
close. Yeah, you really were like a brother and sister.
Hey.
Heard Big Mike is taking you over the pass?
Yep.
You really think she's still alive? Billions of people are dead, but somehow she made it.
Hey, we made it, didn't we? If I give up now, if I don't do this, well, then I'm just gonna end up
like us, right? Like Iron Mike, like Boozer? Would you call us campers? Yeah?
You go. And you find your woman. You know where to find me.
You know what I think, Deacon? I think that you're afraid to be here. You're afraid to be a part of something. We need you here, and that scares the hell out of you.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, me too.
You ready? Yeah, I want to get the hell out of here.
This way.
Okay, I'm following you.
back out fishing once. Before, you know.
No shit.
I got one. Didn't know what the hell to do with it.
That sounds like Jack.
Now you ran a pretty tight club. Or you boys raised some hell back in the day. I don't think you murdered anyone. Not in cold blood.
It's not murder if they shoot at you first.
You know how many tourists we used to get through here come summer?
A few.
Thousands. Too many to count. Highway be bumper to bumper with SUVs and campers chock full of sunburned moms, beer-chugging dads, and their snot-nosed kids. Goddamn rainbow, floppy hats, Hawaiian shirts, and flippy-flops. All summer long they come. A trail of colorful ants from L.A. to Farewell to here, nonstop.
I'm glad I avoided road trips out here that time of year.
This is as far as I go. Keep following the trail. It'll take you down the mountain, on into the Diamond-like Valley. I wish you luck. Hope you're right about your old lady still being alive.
She is.
Well, maybe so. But you gotta ask yourself, Deke, what does it matter if everyone else is dead?
I've idolized, I've memorized your face. Just in case I need to last me eternity. It's a shame that it ain't enough for me. Life's for the living, I won't be giving up. Cause you taught me how to, you taught me how to love. Take all I cherish, beat me till my body's numb. Life's for the living, I won't be giving up. Life's for the living, I won't be giving up on you, on you. Even though I know you would tell me to,
if you're out there, I'll find you.
What the hell?
Keep shooting!
Oh, yeah!
man.
Jesus.
I don't know what we would have done without you, man.
Oh, come on.
Hey, okay, all right, all right, all right. It's dead. It's cool.
Man of the hour.
Oh, God.
I'm Russell, Glenn Russell. This is Private Mullins.
Rick. Hey, Rick. I'm Deacon St. John. Did you say private?
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Deschutes County Militia.
You're not from around here. You come over the pass?
No. I've just been drifting. I came over the salt flats east of Silver Lake.
What the hell are you doing out here, man? How'd you get across the 97?
Whoa. Jesus, man.
What?
This guy just saved your freaking life.
The colonel told us to look out for anybody entering the territory, north or south. Well,
freaking slow your roll, man. We'll let the captain deal with that, okay?
Fine.
He just killed a freaking ranger, dude. Come with us. We got a camp just by Diamond Lake. Get you three hots and a cot. Least we can do.
Okay, yeah, sounds good. What about Flores? We can't just leave him here.
You stay here. I'll come back with some fuel.
No!
Listen, stay here. Use his ammo if you gotta. You'll be fine. Okay? Let's go.
Following you.
Okay, got it. So, Deschutes County Militia?
Look, man, all I know is they feed me. They want me to salute and yes, sir, I salute and say yes, sir.
How big's your outfit?
The camp out here? We got 100, maybe more. Hard to keep track. Back at HQ, a whole lot more than that.
Good.
Any women?
Hell, that what you're about? Well, you can forget it. Earl's got rules about that. Fraternizing. Yeah, that. Look, you pull your weight, follow orders. Nobody messes with you. Women same as the men. Don't matter to the colonel.
I'm not... I'm looking for some people and a woman that I rode with a year back or so. They would have come over from Silver Lake. They would have been at one of those Nero refugee camps, I think.
Silver Lake? Jesus, man. Silver Lake's been gone a lot longer than that.
Yeah. It's too goddamn easy to lose track of time out of here, you know? Anyway, you guys, do you pick anyone up? Survivors, I mean, from the refugee camp?
Maybe. Like I said, it's a big freaking army, you know? Ask the captain. He came in across the Salt Flats, I think. He might know.
Cap?
Yeah, Corey. He commands the Diamond Lake outpost. We're almost there. This is it.
It's Corporal Russell. Open up.
Report.
Captain, sir, we had him. We did. Found his bike, still smoking.
I bet you lost him, huh?
No, sir. I mean, yeah, we lost him. We ran into a rager, sir.
Where's Mullins? Flores?
Flores is dead, sir. I'll have Mullins with a body.
That'll be all, Corporal. Go get some fuel. Head back to Mullins. You know what to do.
Yeah. Yes, sir. If it wasn't for this man, we'd all be dead, sir. I sort of promised him some food and a safe place to camp tonight, sir.
Corporal, get the fuck out of here. And you are?
Name's Deacon St. John.
Name's Corey. Derek Corey. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm sorry. Sorry, I'm a little tired. I've been on the road for a long time. Your man Russell said you were recruiting.
Well, are you interested?
I've been looking to settle down. Yeah, find a camp. I'm interested.
Come on.
So, how long have you been drifting?
Hard to say. You lose track of time out there, you know?
Gear. Ammo.
Well, there's a couple of camps I used to do runs for. Bounty hunting, mostly.
Freaks? Or men?
Both. I had a reputation for being able to track shit down, you know?
Which camps? Where are they?
You know, past the Farewell Valley. It doesn't matter. They're gone now. They're overrun. Russell said you were there when Silver Lake was overrun.
Yeah. That was a shit show, I can tell you.
Any survivors?
A few.
Move! 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 Come!
Here. Take this. Militia script. Camp credits. Payment for helping my men. Use them at any of the commissaries.
Okay.
You gonna join up? Stick around. We're getting ready to ride out of here soon.
Getting ready to ride out where?
You said you had some tracking skills.
Yeah, some.
This isn't the life of a drifter. We're fighting a war out here. You sure you're up for it?
Is that the best you got?
I can recruit you, but the colonel is the only one who can swear you in. You stick around. Give us a hand. I'll take you to him myself.
I'll be here.
Good.
Jesus. Jesus, motherfucker has my ring. He took it from Sarah. He had to take it from Sarah because she wouldn't have given it to him, so that means that she's gotta be here. He doesn't look like militia.
Hey. You don't look very militia to me.
Nah, man. Name's Wade. Wade Taylor. You can call me Wade.
Deacon St. John.
Holy shit. Deacon St. John. Is your old man a preacher or something?
No.
Man, that is a hell of a name.
All right, listen.
You Wade. See this, man? This is some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Whew. So what, you joining up, becoming an army man, you playing soldier and shit?
I don't know, maybe. Listen, you look like you just came in from out the shit, right?
Yeah, man, yesterday. Okay, yesterday. I've been waiting to see the colonel, whatever the hell that is.
Traveling with some people, we got separated. You see anyone that looked like this around here?
Nah, man. Ooh, she is a looker. I'd hit that, you know. I gotta go, man. They're checking me for lice or some shit. Good luck to you, Deacon St. John. Jesus, what a name.
Jesus, that dude's fucked up. He wouldn't remember Sarah if she slapped him in the face. Come on, Sarah, come on. Where the hell are you? You're here. Somewhere. Maybe in these tents. Maybe in here.
Feeling any better?
The infirmary. I mean, with her background, that's where she would be, right? Nope, not here. Check this one. Ah, damn it. She's not here either.
Good day.
No, she wouldn't be in the mechanics area. She never knew a wrench from a screwdriver.
You are new here? I am Lumi Ikeda.
Deacon St. John. You're the bounty collector around here?
Yes, of course. We welcome anyone who will work to make the area safe.
Good.
Oh, all right.
Together, keep it together.
Goodbye to you.
Yes, Sergeant.
Yes, Sergeant. Yes, Sergeant. Yes, Sergeant.
She's not drilling with these clowns. I mean, come on, what am I thinking? Even Let's if she work, were people. Here, she keep would be playing moving. Soldier with this
yes, bunch. Yes, Sergeant. Yes, Sergeant.
What's up?
New around here? Name's Ava Bergstrom. Friends call me Bergie.
Deacon St. John. Yeah, I just got here.
Well, Deacon St. John, you do your job, and we'll get along just fine. How's that?
Yes, ma'am.
See ya.
Hey there.
Hey there.
I haven't seen you around before. Lucas Monroe.
Yeah, I just shipped in, you know. Deacon St. John.
Well, take a look around. I got all kinds of bike parts, if you got credits.
Yeah, thanks.
What are you doing there? Need something? Just let me know.
There you go.
Oh, okay, then. Stop by soon.
She's not in a mess. I mean, that's where... Well, that's where I would be. That's all I got. It's gotta be the one. Sarah? Sarah, you in here? Shit, not here. Oh, God damn it, she's not here. She's not here, but... Right, yeah, it couldn't be that easy. Now, could it? Cute drawings. Oh, God.
St. John, are you on this channel? Corporal Russell said you had a radio.
Yeah, I'm here.
Meet me at the gate.
Why are you not working hard? Why are you still in my obstacle course? Why are you not finished with my obstacle course? Do you like it that much? Do you want to run it again? Then be my guest, princess!
Yes, sir! Moving, sir!
Move! Come on! You can run faster than that. My dead grandma can run faster than that. My dead, crippled grandmother, who was in a goddamn wheelchair, can run faster than you!
Yes!
Yes!
Sir.
Yes!
Moving, sir!
Moving! Sir! Go! You gotta move your ass! You think you're gonna outrun the freaks? Hell no, you're not! Come on, you gotta work!
Yes, Sergeant!
Sergeant! Why are you not working hard? Why are you still in my obstacle course? Why are you not finished with my obstacle course?
Good day.
How's it going?
Getting ready to ride out. You still coming?
Ready when you are.
So you put a lot of work into this.
Yeah, some.
Maybe they ended up there.
I thought maybe you were after someone. For a bounty, I mean.
Yeah, no. I tracked men over long distances before, but not this far. No bounty's worth that.
Captain's here.
It's done, sir.
Make sure you make a marker.
Yes, sir.
All right. You two head back to Diamond Lake. Grab Taylor was his name?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Take him to the colonel. I'll be there in 1800.
Sir?
Military time, Corporal. You're supposed to know this by now.
Oh, yes, sir.
Get the fuck out of here.
Yes, sir.
You find something?
How long is,
Vasquez?
How long has Vasquez been with you guys?
A couple of weeks, maybe more.
Well, he's been busy.
What the hell?
You guys been having trouble with supply runs, marauder attacks?
Yeah.
Okay, we're gonna go on foot from here.
On foot? Why?
Because Vasquez came out here for a reason. I can't track him from the bike.
Where do we start?
It's been snowing, so there won't be any boot prints. Come on, I want to look inside the cabin.
Okay, I'm following you.
You said he stole rations, ammo?
Yes.
This is an MRE. It's half eaten, so looks like your men rode up on him when he wasn't expecting it. His bike's still out front, which means that he went out the back. Scrap. Wait, over here.
What'd you find?
The fence has been cut. And no rust.
So it was cut recently?
Yeah, come on, this way.
Hey, hold on for a second.
Look.
Over here.
Tracks?
Yeah, we're in luck. This way.
Wait, hold up.
You find something?
Yeah, shell casing. Recently fired. He stopped to shoot at something. Come on, down here.
Hold up.
Go on, get out of here.
What are you doing? That ever work for you? Yelling at a wolf?
Yeah, depends.
On what?
On how hungry it is.
I see him.
I want to take a look at this thing. Looks like the MREs weren't enough for your man. Clean gunshot, right through the head.
Heard the shot. Decided they wanted it more than Vasquez.
Yeah, the rest of the pack came at us from back that way, from the east.
They chased off Vasquez.
That's my guess. You guys got a lot of wolves out here? Ones that aren't infected, I mean. When I was a kid growing up, there were no wolves in Oregon. I mean, a few coyotes, but no wolves. They've been driven to extinction by ranchers and farmers, timber companies. Hold up.
It's a backpack. Looks like they almost got to him.
Nah. To buy time. He landed on his ass. Tried to scramble away, but then the wolf lunged. Vasquez dropped him. Two shots. Yeah.
Right there with you.
I gotta say, I get tired running and hiding from these sons of bitches.
You ever take on a swarm?
Yeah, I've done it before.
You just gotta keep moving.
Well, look, you're gonna join the militia? You must stay focused on the mission. We're not out here to fight freaks.
Being a shit, killing freaks, kind of goes hand in hand, doesn't it?
Okay,
put some distance between us and the graves. The cold weather's gonna bring out even more of them. I think they can smell the corpse from about a mile out.
Part of our slash and burn strategy is to find these grave sites, dig them up, and burn them along with everything else.
Yeah, well, good luck with that. I've seen hundreds of them just in this part of the state alone.
Yeah, we've got to start somewhere. All right, where now?
Keep heading east. Hey, there's a road ahead. Hold up a second.
What do you think?
Is anyone else tracking him?
Not that I know of.
Huh. Well, then he's either dead, or he's got a lot of friends. You see how his tracks have been overridden by bikes. A lot of bikes.
Okay. Come on. Let's see where they're heading.
You said cold weather brings out the freaks?
Yeah. Cold, snow, rain, hell, even clouds.
Well, like I said before, you know your freaks. When we get to command, there's some people who want to talk to you.
People?
The colonel will fill you in, if he lets you join.
Yeah, I think you said that already.
Look, he runs a tight outfit. I just don't want you to get your hopes up.
Hey, don't worry about me. I don't really give a damn either way.
Hey, wait.
Hear that?
Yeah, it's coming from the logging camp over there.
Is that on your map?
Yeah.
Oh, that means it's also on Vasquez's map.
Come on. If Vasquez is there, what would your strategy be?
Well, he's not alone. We know that from the tracks. What's that militia penalty for going AWOL?
Hanging by the neck until dead. Why?
Well, it means Vasquez isn't coming without a fight. Do you see your man?
Yeah, that's him.
Well, looks like you guys need to start doing background checks on your recruits. He seems to be right at home.
Well, let's wait here. I'll radio for backup.
Get your goddamn hands off me!
Oh, this one's a fighter, boys! What do you think?
Oh, let's see about that. Oh, yeah.
What?
I just got this problem with assholes who hurt unarmed women.
I'm giving you an order.
Order?
You see me wearing a red armband? You don't give me orders yet. You do whatever the hell you want.
coming. Think you're gonna win there?
I'm gonna choke the life out of you.
Not gonna open. Locked tight. There we go. Open.
Thank you.
gonna open. open.
Incoming!
He isn't my man. Not anymore.
Hey, whoa. Easy, easy. I'm just here to help.
I don't need your goddamn help.
Okay. I'm just gonna move over here.
Stay the hell away from me!
Hold on now. We're not with them.
You think I give a damn who you are?
Okay.
Stand guard in case we missed anyone.
You can handle him.
He won't know what hit him.
What the hell was that?
Just your typical damsel in distress.
Captain Corey, come in.
This is Corey.
We're here, heading up the road to the main gate.
Hold your position there. We're coming.
Enemy.
They've been neutralized. Hold your position. Curry out. Come on.
We brought up your bikes, Captain. Thought we'd save you the walk back.
That'll be all, Corporal.
So how'd I do? Did I pass?
Pass?
Well, you've been watching me all day. I figured this was, what, some kind of test?
No. Nothing quite as formal as all that. As you can see, our pool of recruits isn't what it used to be.
Yeah.
But yeah. You passed.
Third day in a row.
Oh. You ready to meet the colonel?
Yeah, sure. Why the hell not?
So, St. John, where did you serve? Before the ship went down. You know what an MRE looks like. You know how to recon an enemy position. You know cover in advance, tactical maneuvers. So, where did you serve? Marines? Army?
I try not to talk about it, you know? First year out here, seemed like anyone who used to wear a uniform had a target on their back. I was in the Army, 10th Mountain. I did a full tour in Afghanistan. So how about you? Anyone who's ex-military has a certain bearing. None of your soldiers have it, but you do.
Like I said, you got a good eye. I was in the Air Force 10 years, part of SAC.
There ain't no missile silos in Oregon.
I was on vacation, believe it or not. I was lucky. Before SATCOM went down, I got hourly reports from across the country. You think it was bad out here? Everything east of the Mississippi was overrun within 2 days.
Thank you.
show you something.
So, are you familiar with this area?
Yeah, I grew up in a town north from here. It's called Farewell, you know it?
No. It sounds like a fitting place to be living at the end of the world.
Yeah, tell me about it.
So maybe you have been here before.
Yeah, I've been here. A few summers back, me and my old lady, or my wife, stopped by here on her honeymoon.
You got a pic? Of your wife, I mean. Her name was Carrie. We were married 12 years when... Anyway, it was a long time ago.
You know, I think this might mean keep out.
Huh? Oh, no, that doesn't apply to us.
Why, because we can't read?
Because we don't obey the law.
Speak for yourself.
After you.
All right. You know, making me a co-conspirator, not very chivalrous.
Chival what?
It means, right. I never learn. I'm sorry about that.
Oh my God, you should have seen the look on your face.
Oh, I bet it was funny.
Yeah, if I'd owned a cell phone, I'd have taken a picture.
Well, for just this once, I'm glad that you don't.
Oh, come on, don't start on that again.
Hey, I didn't say anything. You brought it up.
You just did. Just follow the trail. You'll see that it's not that far.
What would my mom say if she was out on a midnight stroll in the middle of nowhere with an outlaw right now?
I don't know. She'd say, honey, you better wear your sweater.
Very funny.
Yeah, she wouldn't say anything, you know? You weren't supposed to tell them about us, remember?
Come on, Deacon, I said that a long time ago. You know I didn't mean that.
Hey, look, I'm not judging. I haven't told my old man.
That's because your father's dead.
Well, yeah, I mean, there's that.
Question is, have you told anyone in the MC that you're dating a nice girl from Seattle and not some bimbo from whatever strip club you guys live in?
Oh, well, okay, wait a second. No, we don't live in a strip club. I mean, we have a lifetime membership there, that's true, but we don't live there. And second, I did tell them. Yeah, matter of fact, I did.
Wait, you did?
Yeah. Oh, come on, don't sound so surprised. They find your PhDs to be very sexy.
I bet. you know this is way past my bedtime.
Oh, I know.
Come on, stop. I mean, I really do have to get up early tomorrow.
Yeah? How's that going? I mean,
you never want to talk about it, so...
It's nothing. It's just... it's just this project. I mean, we've got these execs flying in from New York to audit our progress, and the suits at our facility are installing a new lab without even choking me to spec, and...
Well, I thought you didn't want to talk about it.
Sorry, it's just... You know what? Like I said, it's nothing. Anyway, thank you for dragging me away from all that.
Yeah. No problem.
Wait, is this a pot farm? Is this what you wanted to show me?
Say what?
Well, these are marijuana plants, and that's an irrigation system, so this here, this is a pot farm.
Oh, hey, yeah, look at that. Pot farm.
You dragged me out in the middle of the night to the middle of nowhere to show me the MC's illegal growing operation.
Yeah. I mean, you got me. I was hoping that you could give us some tips, you know, cultivation. Put all those PhDs to work on something actually useful.
Jesus, DQ, what? Okay, I get it. This is not actually what you wanted to show me, right?
No, of course it's not. Come on,
keep following the trail. We're almost there.
You think I would learn? You think I would learn, but I never learn.
Nope.
God, look at that moonlight. It's so beautiful.
Keep going. We're almost there.
You ever wonder what it would be like if just everywhere all at once the lights went out and everyone could just see the world just like this?
What, you mean like all dark and shadowy and depressing?
I mean the moonlight, the wildflowers, the fireflies. I see you were kidding again. Okay, you don't take anything seriously.
Oh, I take everything seriously.
Oh, yeah, right.
I do.
You do not. Like when I suggested moving some of my stuff over to your place, you pretended that I was joking.
No, that's not true. I pretended I didn't hear you. There's a big difference.
You should have seen the look on your face. And you know, I do have a cell phone and I took a picture. You want me to show you?
My God, you're a scientist. Can we be rational about this?
Okay. First of all I said is that we should think about moving in together. You know, because we get to spend more time together and, you know, take the next step. What's irrational about that?
I have a toothbrush at your place.
Oh, I'm so sorry. You know what? You're right. That is a huge commitment.
Well, I mean, do you know how much a good toothbrush costs?
Okay, see, there you go again. Every time I try to talk about our future, you turn it into a joke.
Okay, all right. We do need to talk about it. And we will talk about it, but just hold on for a second, because I want to show you something, okay? See? This is why I brought you out here.
Wow, how beautiful.
Was it worth it?
God, yes.
Hey, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
Yeah?
Will you...
Will I?
Will you, So that a yes?
On two conditions.
Name them.
Okay, well, the first one is that we don't have one of those biker weddings where you say that you're gonna ride me as much as your bike.
Done. I couldn't promise that anyway.
Oh, stop. Okay, the second one is that you never leave me.
Done.
God, did you just break your biker ring off my finger?
You know what? I guess you probably did.
Look at it. It's so cute with this little bang. It's just like clenching onto the chain. You know, nothing says true love like
dog skulls.
Dog skulls. Hey, what does it say there?
Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you knew Latin.
Come on.
It's Morier Invictus. It means death before defeat.
Wow, I like that. Well, you're gonna get me like a real ring, though, right? Not that this one's not
absolutely
great.
Because I just thought that's my ring.
Right, it's your ring. Right. Something more simple, without fangs.
Okay.
Shit, I'm sorry.
No, it's your ring.
It's the lab. I gotta get it.
Okay.
Hello? Yeah. No, it's fine. I'll be right there. Okay, bye.
Is everything okay?
I don't know. They need me back there. What? I gotta go.
This minute? Like, this time of night?
I'm sorry. I have to go, but I promise I'll make it up to you.
Okay.
Come on.
My wife's name was, Beth. No, I don't have a pick. Let's go.
Not unusual, you know.
I'm sorry, what's that?
To not have any photos of your wife, family.
Yeah, why do you say that?
Back in the day, everyone used smartphones. That's where we kept all our photos. When phones went away, the cloud went away, our photos went with them.
Yeah, I guess I hadn't thought about that.
My wife, Carrie. Her father was a photographer. Old school. Dark room, chemicals, all that. Too stubborn to embrace the digital age, I think. If it wasn't for him, I wouldn't have any photos either.
Yeah, well, I hated them. Cell phones, I mean. It seemed like everyone walked around with their noses buried in the damn things. I never owned one.
Interesting. How'd you manage that?
I worked as a mechanic. I had my own shop. Probably had the last landline in Farewell.
You guys are taking this shit seriously.
Colonel believes with enough motivation and discipline, we can achieve anything.
Come on, hurry your ass up!
I'm going as fast as I can!
Just move it!
Is that your idea of motivation?
Colonel has set up a work camp on the south side of the island for those unfit to serve. Some of them require extra encouragement.
I'll bet.
Come on, follow me.
Yes, sir.
Stand up there with the others. Good luck, St. John.
Got your ass too, huh? Whatever.
Hey, man. It's good to see you again. St. John, right? Son of a preacher man?
Taylor, what's this son of a preacher man shit you keep saying?
I'm just kidding with you, man. Hey, do you have any luck?
What?
The woman you were looking for, you and your peeps are riding with.
No.
I need all your jewelry, watches, shit like that. Come on, in the bag.
Sure, man, whatever you say.
The hell you say?
Recruits aren't allowed personal effects. Besides, shit's just gonna get stolen. Come on, cough it up.
Oh, yeah, shit's gonna get stolen.
Goddamn bullshit.
Ten hot! At ease. Visitors are not welcome here. You are here because you were invited, recruited by my trusted officers. When you answer me, start by giving me your name, last name first.
Getting by, same as everybody.
Name.
Atkins, Crystal, sir.
How many men have you killed?
Before or after?
Answer the question.
Fuck you!
We've all done things that we're not proud of.
What?
To survive, to stay alive. The Almighty understands this.
Right.
The Almighty forgives
Amen.
This.
Amen!
But here, on this woman's face, are the footprints of Satan. Prison tattoos. Proof of what you once were and no doubt still are. It's people like her that are responsible for bringing the wrath of the Almighty down upon us all.
Yeah, that's right.
Take her to the work camp.
What? You!
Get her out of here!
Fuck you!
Come on, gorgeous! Let's go!
Goddamn redneck assholes! Get off of me!
Swear to God!
What about you?
Taylor. Wade. And, no. Sir. I never been to jail. Never killed anyone, nothing like that.
You've been in the shit for a long time.
Yeah, I mean, I know. I know how to shoot stuff. My dad took me hunting when I was a kid. He was at a camp near Klamath Falls. It got...
And how about you, son? You know how to use a gun?
St. John, Deacon. Yeah, I know how to use a gun.
You're a drifter. Hold out your right arm. 10th Mountain. Iraq?
Afghanistan.
Honorable service, and don't lie to me. I'll know.
Served one tour, served with honor, hated every goddamn minute of it.
Thou shalt not lie. Good man. Hold up your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to support and defend the new Constitution of these United States? Against all enemies, natural and unnatural, to bear witness and support to the same, and to obey all orders without question. So, do you swear?
I swear.
Dismissed! Walk with me, son.
How's it going, soldier?
Captain Curry doesn't bring me many recruits these days. He must think highly of your combat skills.
I've been in the shit a long time.
You know your way around the freaks?
Yes, sir. I know as much as anyone, sir.
Good, good. In here. We'll have the doc take a look at you.
Pulse is strong. Good heart rate. Got a pretty nasty burn there. How'd that happen?
Had a run-in with a wood stove.
Wood stove, huh? Who dressed this?
I did.
No está mal. Not bad at all.
Thank you.
Keep it dressed or you're gonna lose that arm. You hear me, amigo?
Yeah, I hear you.
I want you to check back with me in a few days.
Got it.
Well, Doc?
He's fit to serve. Lo hará bien. You doing runs out in the shit?
Sorry, Doc. Ya tiene novia. He's spoken for.
Let me guess. The Wizard Island Witch. Vaya con Dios. Good luck, amigo.
Let's go, son.
I normally don't tolerate insubordination, referring to an officer as a witch. But I make exceptions for some of my more eccentric officers.
Yes, sir.
I make exceptions because every man and woman still living has a role to play. Do you believe in God, St. John?
Never gave it much thought, sir.
Well, it's high time that you did. He has a plan for us, all of us. And my part is this.
Sir?
This place. I had a vision. Oh, nothing so grand as those described in the Old Testament. No flaming chariots or burning bushes. I simply woke up one morning before God's plague had rained down upon the world and knew that this was the place.
Crater Lake, Wizard Island?
I call it the Ark. Are you familiar with the story?
Yeah, I mean, yes, sir. I mean, everyone's heard of it.
Indeed. You'd be surprised how few have read the Bible or the Book of Revelations.
You mean Genesis, Noah's story. I mean, that... It's the Book of Genesis, sir.
Yes, of course. Okay, son, let's get you squared away.
Whatever you say.
Now, we don't have much in the way of uniforms, I'm sorry to say, but I think that... Here. Try this on.
Seems to fit.
I'll take that.
Well, if you don't mind, this is a gift from an old friend.
An old friend? Not many of those left anymore, are there?
No, there are not.
Okay, soldier. But I don't want to see you wearing it. You're one of us now. And normally we start new recruits in the rank of private. But since Captain Curry has vouched for your experience in the field, we are starting you out at the rank of corporal. Congratulations, son.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Let's get you some work.
All right. Now, what was I saying?
You were telling me about the Ark, sir.
Yes, the Ark. What you see here is only a small part of it. Behind us is a whole network of caves and vents that lead from here up to the Cone's Peak. When our work is complete, they will be filled with thousands of seeds, plants, computer files, and books. The world may die, but our achievements in medicine, science, and technology will not die with it.
No, sir.
But the island is more than just an ark, Corporal. It is a stronghold, a fortress. Here at the North Gate, we are stockpiling enough munitions to take the fight to the freaks. We have rifles, grenades, heavy machine guns, and RPGs. We have the equipment to make ammunition. Every type, every caliber. This is our mechanical engineering area. If you need your bike repaired, see the officer on duty. And as you can see here, courtesy of the old National Guard, we are building a fleet of trucks and other vehicles. Once the hordes are cleared from the highways, we will begin to rebuild the roads and bridges.
Your slash-and-burn strategy may stop newts and swarmers, but it won't clear the highway. It won't stop the hordes, sir.
We are aware, Corporal. The hordes. The hordes are a different beast entirely, aren't they? But we have a plan.
Plan, sir?
Benjamin Franklin once said, by failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail.
We are not going to fail. The heart of the army lives here, at the gate, ready to move on my command. These tents house hundreds of women and men, just like yourself, who have pledged and sworn their lives to the fight. But I have something else in mind for you. An assignment that requires more than just the ability to survive in the shit or use a gun. Are you up for it, son?
I hate
school. Yes, sir. Wherever you need me.
Yeah.
You asked how we were going to defeat the Horde. Let me show you.
Hey.
Don't get in my way.
How long have we been standing here?
Whoa! Now! Shit!
You okay, Lieutenant?
Oh. Hey, Colonel. Sorry about that. Too much acetone in that batch.
Lieutenant Weaver is our chemical engineer. He's working on new ways
to blow shit up.
Defeat the enemy.
Sorry. But, yeah. Name's Weaver. James.
St. John, Deacon.
All this militia shit's just for show. Right, Colonel?
Corporal St. John is new to Corey's unit. If you need anything from out in the shit, he's your man.
Oh, shit, yeah. Yeah, there's a couple of things I need.
What are you working on?
Oh, just the new gelling agent combining naphthenic and palmitic acid.
You working on napalm?
Yeah. Yeah, this dude knows his shit.
Just a lucky guess.
Sorry to interrupt.
Oh, anytime. Oh, Colonel. I'm getting real close, Colonel. Very close.
That's good. That's really good.
Where you going next, Colonel? Wizard Island Witch?
That'll be all, Lieutenant. Again, let me apologize for my more eccentric officers. Today.
No need, sir.
We have one final stop. As much as I believe in Lieutenant Weaver's work, what you're about to see could be, I think, our path to victory.
All right, what is this?
Ma'am, I got everything on the requisition form.
Does this look like fabric softener?
No, ma'am.
Okay, well, why don't you read it?
Active ingredients. Chloroform and A-terpene...
Get out.
Shit.
Get out! I can't do this if I have to do my own supply runs.
I got it covered. Lieutenant Whitaker, this is Corporal St. John. He's a new member of Corey's unit. He's got some experience out in the shit.
Read this.
What?
Read this. I mean, you can read, can't you?
Active ingredients, chloroform, a-terpenol, benzyl alcohol, ethyl acetate.
Good enough. When can he start?
Ah, I'll leave you to it. Carry on, Lieutenant.
Leave us.
Sir.
Stand at attention. Dead. You're supposed to be dead.
Hey.
You're dead.
It's okay.
You're dead.
I'm right here.
Wait a second. I don't understand. I couldn't find you.
I thought that you had died, and I,
No, we were overrun. And we had to go south. Nero, they said that no one made it out. Farewell was overrun. They said that everybody was dead.
Man, I didn't think that
I never thought I would see you again.
Hey, listen, now we can ride out of here. We'll pick a direction. We won't look back. Come on.
No, Deacon. I can't.
Are they forcing you to stay here?
No, you don't understand. We're fighting a war. Don't you see? This is a war that we can win.
I ain't coming here to fight a war.
I can be helpful. I can make a difference, but I can't go with you. I have to stay here. Don't you get it? You can stay here with me. Help me. Look, afterwards, whatever you say, we can go wherever you want.
Colonel's looking for you.
Whatever you say, ma'am.
Wait a second. Your requisition form. Thank you, soldier.
Corporal St. John to Lieutenant Weaver. Come back. St. John to HQ.
This is Weaver. What can I do for you, Corporal?
Your requisition form says you need mercury. Any idea where I can get it?
Yeah, sure. I should have written that shit down for you. It comes from, Cinnabar. Corey's unit scouted out of mine north of Diamond Lake. Head there, radio me when you arrive.
Yes, sir.
Hey, between you and me? If the colonel isn't around, stop with all the yes sir, no sir bullshit, all right? Makes me feel old.
Corporal. Hey.
Sarge.
New guy? Name's Caleb. Caleb Tomlinson.
Deacon St. John. Yeah, I just rode in.
Oh, cool, man. Hey, listen, if you need something for your ride, you come see me. Between us, Lucas, the Canuck over at Diamond Lake, he'll rip you off, man.
Great, well, keep that in mind.
Yeah, okay. Well, okay then. Corporal, later.
Hey, you. I haven't seen you around here before. Name's Jacob D'Angelo. Everybody calls me D.
St. John, Deacon. So, you're the guy to come to for hardware?
You got it, pal. You need guns? I got guns. If I don't have it, it was never made, you know what I mean?
Great. I'll keep that in mind.
Come on, man. Corporal, see you around.
Hey, I'm new around here. Name's Deacon St. John.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Ella Salazar. Just call me Sal.
So, this is where I bring bounty ears?
Mm-hmm. This is the place. If you have any freaker ears, bring them to me.
Got it.
Okay, then. Corporal, goodbye.
Corporal.
Sarge, how's it going? That's all I got today.
Corporal St. John, is it?
Yes, sir.
Come in. Just enjoying a cup of tea, herbal, courtesy of Lieutenant Whitaker. Would you like to try some? It's very good for the digestion.
No, sir. Thank you, sir. I was just looking for the duty roster.
I have an assignment for you. Men, Corporal. Not that they deserve to be called that. They've taken one of ours. Lieutenant Justine Norwood. Fine officer.
And they have her, so, yes, I will get her back, sir.
With the help of men like you, we're going to take back this world. Dismissed.
John, come in. This is Captain Curry. I've got a job for you.
Captain Curry, hit the Diamond Lake outpost, I assume? Copy that.
is St. John. Corporal St. John. You got your ears on, man? Hey, does this thing even work? Oh, thanks, Ranger.
Yeah, your radio works. What's up?
Deacon St. John. Hey, nothing. Just checking in on you. I haven't seen you since the whole swearing in thing. That was some shit.
Taylor, I'm kind of busy.
What the hell you got you doing? I'm in the damn infantry or some shit. Spend all day burning out nests, chopping down trees, hauling wood. So, sorry. What are you doing?
Research. They got me going out into the shit, finding supplies for the officers, working on.
Oh shit! Oh, I heard about that. Yeah. Working on bioweapons, chemical weapons, shit like that. Burn them freaks to the ground. Am I right?
Yeah. Look. Taylor, I gotta go.
All right. Hey, look, man. It's just, I'm having second thoughts about all this military shit, you know.
Keep with us. Open up.
What radio are you on? Are you sure? Not being monitored.
Oh, shit.
Huh. That's what I thought. Gotta go. St. John out.
Corporal, good. I have a job that requires your unique skills.
Yes, sir.
You remember Vasquez?
The man that went AWOL. Yeah, we tracked him to the logging camp, I remember.
Well, this man, Sergeant Lee Anderson, was his partner. He was about to be arrested when he killed a guard and took off.
Oh, your men have quite the code of honor.
Our men? You're one of us now, remember? I've marked the location on where he was last seen on your map. Apparently, like Vasquez, he wasn't alone.
Great.
Hold on, I got this.
Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Feds were whining babies, suckling at the teat of us taxpayers. But dumb as they were, we can't underestimate them. You gotta know that Chief Muckety Mucks are hiding out there in some bunker, waiting for the freaks to die off. They didn't save the hungry, or their precious constituents. You know the real reason they're in power. They save the elite. The men and women who played ball. They're sitting underground, probably drinking champagne while they wait. Meanwhile, we're out here dying, suffering. Also, the feds can hit the damn reset button. But they didn't account for one thing. We're not as stupid as they thought we were. And once they emerge to reclaim the world when the freaks are gone, we'll be waiting. Oh, yes, we will. And they'll be sorry they ever came out of hiding. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Ah, Jesus, even all the way down here, I can't get away from goddamn Radio Free Oregon. Screamer, no. I got a use for you. Got it.
me.
Corporal Deacon St. John. Hey, you got your ears on, man? Hey.
Taylor, what do you need?
There you are. Okay. So I finally figured out how to use this damn thing. Alright, I got a secure channel and everything. So how's it going, man?
Taylor, I'm kind of busy right now, so...
Yeah. Sorry, man, sorry. hey, so, word's out in the camp. The trucks are making...
God damn it, not now!
Charge him!
Yeah, sorry, man, sorry. the trucks are making their way in.
They're down!
I don't do drugs, Taylor. No, I don't know anything about it. Why?
No. I don't either. I'm just a sketchy guy. You know, one of the new recruits has most suspicions. He rides in and out of camp all the time, and so I thought I'd follow him, right? To see what the hell he's about.
Ah, goddamn it. Taylor, listen to me. You just go to Corey, let him handle it. You got that?
Yeah. That's a good call. Yeah. Okay, Mr. St. John, I'll talk to you later, man. Out.
Jesus Christ, Taylor, what the hell are you doing? Sniper ambush. Oh, goddammit. Okay.
Finally. Jesus.
You like that, huh?
Shoot him, you fucking bastard. Thank you.
Captain Khoury, with Cyber Sergeant Anderson's last scene.
All right, Anderson, let's go take care of business. No, he's gotta be here somewhere. Where the hell is he? Take a closer look.
Dead coyote. Marauder camp. These are the assholes who've been ambushing the roads around here. Gotta get into that camp.
All right.
301, dead coyote lava cave. Ironically named since we're here inspecting the remains of a Canis lupus mutans. Runners, as the locals like to call.
Hey, I've been meaning to ask one of you guys.
Well, you guys.
It's a little under the weather.
In the research division, how'd the virus, you know, jump?
You mean, how did it jump species?
Yeah. I mean, we've seen it in cats, dead dogs, birds, lava cave. I didn't
nothing
think it was
bad
possible.
Can happen
you know
with a name
viral,
like that,
zoonotic,
yeah?
Neuroinvasive disease is, Corporal? No, don't have a clue. Think rabies. Just like the hooligan virus. Rabies spreads through contact with fluids. Saliva, blood, semen. That's just gross. And while it primarily infects mammals, lab cultures have shown that it can also infect birds, reptiles, even insects. Do you know how many mammals there are in the world? A lot, I'm guessing.
Yes, a lot. 5,488 to be exact, depending on who you ask. All of which, cats, rabbits, dogs, horses, skunks, possums, foxes, monkeys, groundhogs, and yes, wolves, can be infected and can spread the virus.
Jesus. What's it mean? For us, I mean.
Look at the musculature on this subject. Swollen and distended supraglenoid the ulnar and radial tuberous.
I am a man.
Run 31 to 37 miles per hour.
Enemy now!
60.
Yeah, not bad.
Another bounty. Yeah. That's kind of interesting. Okay, now just gotta go back and take this in. Thank you.
on with Captain Curry. Let him in.
Let's work, people. Keep moving. Yes, Sergeant. Yes, sir. Yes,
Captain, I found your man, Anderson, and you were right. He still had his militia insignia.
He's dead?
Well, let's just say that he had a run-in with a pack of wolves long before I got to him.
That's a fitting end for a murderer and a thief.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, Corporal. Dismissed.
Service. I mean, yeah, I miss the swearing in, but I can always tell when someone served. You know what I mean?
4 years, 10th Army, Afghanistan. Like I told the colonel, I hated every goddamn minute of it. How about you?
Yeah. Why are you not? You got the eye for it too,
why
huh?
Are you still in
me?
My course?
No,
why are
you not nothing so grandiose course? Like you. Do you like it? National Guard. Do you want to run it again? 8 years. I actually kind of loved it, you know, pushing pencils and sailing and playing soldier on the weekends. But you're the real deal.
We all did our part.
Yeah, we did it that. That is true.
Who is in a goddamn wheelchair can run faster than you?
Yes,
moving.
See you, Corporal. Keep that gun close, you hear me?
So, where are you from, Lucas? Was it? I can't place your accent.
That obvious. Yeah, from Canada, originally. Yeah, I was down here on holiday with the family. Yeah, doing a bit of camping out, you know, west of Crater Lake. A wife and kids. My boys would have been 8 and 9 this year.
Canada? Oh, you're a long way from home.
Oh, tell me about it. Yeah, I was a teacher. Engine repair in Calgary at the Technical Institute. Oh, you ever been? No, I guess not. Anyways, the colonel, he gave me this job, so now this is home, yeah?
Yeah.
Let's work!
I got the gate.
Together, keep it together. Move it, Sergeant.
Corporal St. John. Wade Taylor to Deacon St. John.
Taylor, I hear a bike. Tell me you're not out in the shit tracking down that drug trafficker.
Okay. I won't tell you that. But I am.
God damn it, Taylor, you're gonna get yourself killed.
No, man, no. Hey, I followed a bunch of them up the highway.
Highway 97?
Hey, it was daylight, the weather was clear, I didn't see a single freak. But there is this group of men ended up at the ski lodge. Did you even know there was a ski lodge out here? I didn't know that.
Taylor.
It's a sweet-ass setup, too. If I ever decide to bug out, that is where I'm going. Oh, shit! I gotta run. They're stopping at another camp. Taylor, out.
Taylor.
Taylor, God damn it.
Okay, let's take a look around. Okay, let's see. What's going on here? Back on track.
Beacon St. John to Captain Corey. St. John to Corey, come back.
St. John, I've just spoken with the Colonel. He's assigned you to the Research Division?
Captain, Research Division, yeah, I guess you would call it that. I'm helping Lieutenant Weaver and Lieutenant Whitaker.
You asshole! You killed him!
Need this more than you. You were saying something?
Good. They can use all the help you can offer.
I don't know how much help I'm gonna be, and just sort of their errand boy for now. And actually, that's why I radioed in. Lieutenant Whitaker gave me a requisition form that says yeast.
Yeast? Hold a second. We have patrols making supply runs throughout the region. When they come across anything of potential value, they note it down. Yes. Here. The yeast and other baking supplies were noted in the kitchen area of the Crater Lake Visitor's Center. You know where that is?
Yeah, I could find it.
Good luck, Corporal. Curry out.
Get in there.